Let's talk about something that has garnered a lot of attention throughout the globe. China is working diligently to build the most powerful military in history. Assume that there is a major shift in the way that nations interact with one another, and that the primary reason behind this shift is China becoming increasingly adept at maintaining a powerful military. China has been investing an enormous amount of effort over the course of the last few decades to establish an armed force that is capable of defeating anyone. Not only is this a relatively minor settlement, but it turns out to be an exceptionally important one that has sparked the interest of nations all over the globe. In this video, we will take a closer look at what is going on and seek out the reasons behind China's efforts to have the strongest military in the world. Let's get started with it. A historical look at People's Liberation Army operations. Before getting straight to the military progress, let's first have a little introductory talk about China's armed forces. The Army, Navy, Air Force, Rocket Force, and Strategic Support Force are the five divisions that jointly make up the Chinese Armed Forces, which is also referred to as the People's Liberation Army, PLA. Those who are unaware of this fact should know that the Chinese Army is officially known as the People's Liberation Army Ground Force. Of the 3.13 million people serving in military service, 2.5 million are part of this category. A portion of the total revenue for the military is allotted to them. Everyone knows that the Chinese military's primary edge is its ability to link up and gain intelligence. China maintains a high level of military preparedness, despite its reputation for preferring diplomatic approaches for dispute resolution. Their military force is constantly being strengthened through enhanced training. China has a long history of military interactions, including the Sino-Indian Border War of 1962 and its interfering role in the Korean War, which lasted from 1950 to 1953. With the disputed region under Chinese authority, China accomplished its goals. In the same way, China's forceful actions against Vietnam, when it entered Cambodia, with the intention of ousting the Khmer Rouge leadership, were aimed at forcing Vietnam to remove its forces from Cambodia. In addition, China, Taiwan, and Japan are engaged in border disputes related to the supremacy of the Diaoyu Island, which is located in the East China Sea. The Chinese Army is also in charge of overseeing and monitoring this region. The entire number of naval vessels controlled by the People's Liberation Army, as stated in the reports, is now 174,000 units in the field force. There are a total of 4,950 containers, 2,795 autonomous artillery facilities, 1,434 towed artillery facilities, and an incredible 3,145 rocket artillery facilities. Their normal issue weaponry includes 46 distinct kinds of assault weapons, machine guns, and handguns, and 38 different kinds of grenades. The actual number of their weapons is something that we just cannot know with absolute certainty. China's dream, ambition, power, and national defense. The current focus of the Chinese people is on fulfilling the Chinese dream of regenerating their country through the formation of a great revolutionary modern state that excels in all areas. What is the value of the Chinese dream? Like the United States and its message about the American dream, the China dream serves as a reminder that big superpowers require huge stories. The Chinese leadership is of the belief that they need the strongest military in the world if they are to accomplish the China dream and succeed in the Great Revival. Only a powerful military can ensure the safety of a nation state, so an effective armed force is essential for any powerful nation. Some worry that China is building up its military might in preparation for a conflict with the US. However, that is not the case. The fundamental goal of China's upgrade of its military is to strengthen the country's defenses, increase its global impact, and boost its strategic importance. The United States isn't the only country on edge. Taiwan is too, because of a violent history between the two. Even as of right now, there is no indication that China intends to launch a strike on Taiwan in the near future. On the other hand, Philip Davidson, the 25th U.S. Indo-Pacific Command Chief, said in 2021 that China may launch an invasion against Taiwan by 2027. What is going on in the very end is not quite evident to us. China's 2035 target, a peerless military for the 21st century's stage. China's defense spending has skyrocketed in recent years, contributing to the country's massive army development. There was an annual rise of around 10% in China's military expenditure during 2016. But after that, the rise decreased to 5.7%. In 2023, China's defense funding was over $225 billion, ranking next only to the US, as reported by insiders within the People's Republic of China administration. When it comes to the quantity of assets that are allocated to the military, the budget may not be accurate. United States Senator Dan Sullivan has asserted that, according to official government projections, China's yearly defense budget is approximately $700 billion. That is nearly identical to the United States defense budget of slightly over $800 billion for 2023 and far more than previously projected. Even Major General Cameron Holt, a U.S. Air Force official, made it obvious during his trip that China had been collecting weapons at a pace 5 to 6 times faster than America. At this point, we have no idea what the real facts are. Perhaps China is trying to hide for the time being and will emerge once it has assembled the world's strongest military. Are you aware that China has set a goal to become a military nation that can compete with the world's best by the year 2035? There is a worldwide battle for power that is taking place. As the United States shaped the 20th century, China is constructing an empire that will enable it to do the same in the 21st. The global reach backed by military might. There has been a meteoric rise in China's military strength within the past decade. What really drove China's rise is the most compelling question about the economic growth of the nation. There is no need to go back 50 years. In fact, the majority of these developments have taken place in the last 20 years. Have a look at the Chinese economy 20 years ago. It was much less than that of France at that time. They possessed an army that was so meaningless that it couldn't even count as a military. Because of China's extremely low defense budget, the country's navy was unable to travel beyond the shore. Yet at this very moment, China's military power ranks among the world's top three. So how did it get there? As is typical, it reached its goal mostly through the consumption of an enormous sum of money. The amount of money spent on military service, as well as the attention paid to leaders, was substantially raised. Since the year 2000, China's defense budget has increased 12-fold. To get an impression of the enormousness of China's ambition to accomplish its national targets, one need only look beyond the Belt and Road Initiative, which is the country's plan to build an international road system that is worth $1 trillion. The initial idea behind this project was to provide a road link between East Asia and Europe. Since then, the extent of the task has grown to include Latin America, Africa, and Oceania, greatly increasing China's global political and financial clout. Why China's military might isn't just about budget. At this point, you might be thinking that the United States military expenditure is roughly 4 times that of China's, yet it continues to be the most powerful. You are incorrect at this point. What is the reason for this? There are different aims at play, so just because the US has an enormous spending plan doesn't mean that its armed forces are 4 times stronger. Power expansion is something that the United States of America has always been attempting to do all over the world. The nation of America allocates an enormous amount of its financial resources to the worldwide battle against terror in the Middle East. The obvious benefit is China's less expensive labor and reduced building costs in the defense industry. The United States finances allow it to fulfill its role as the world's defender of the labor international order. China, on the other hand, has smaller financial resources, and that expenditure is mainly spent in one area. The United States maintains dozens of bases globally, whereas China maintains just one. Thus, they are, in fact, enhancing their military might in the area. China is concentrating on infrastructural development as the US is occupied with global surveillance. To question US authority, China is actually being very realistic regarding how to equalize and increase its military capabilities. In the present day, they attain this by creating weapons that are less expensive to manufacture than the targets they harm. A lot of people are worried that the US is slipping behind in technology because of the larger strategic mindset which China has better off than America. Now that we're on the topic of Chinese weaponry, let's have a peek at some of the most impressive ones that are due to be released. Reportedly, the Chinese military is developing a wide range of weapon systems, including carrier killers, railguns, knife weapons, and more. The first we have is China's version of mother-of-all bombs. Some have speculated that China's North Industries Group Corporation Limited has created an incredible nuclear weapon that rivals the United States' mother-of-all bombs, the most deadly non-nuclear missile in the world. The enormous catastrophic capability of this weapon has given it the same nickname, mother-of-all bombs, in the Chinese context, which comes in second in severity to nuclear arms. While the American bomb is heavier, the Chinese one is shorter, measuring 5 or 6 meters in length. It's possible that the enormous explosion it produces will destroy land barriers. Have you heard about the Chinese strategy of building up super soldiers? A wide range of sci-fi weaponry, including assault rifles that can launch grenades, handguns with corner shots, and knife guns, is being supplied to China's elite security forces by the military. The grenade-launching combat rifle combines a rifle's and a grenade launcher's functions with an enhanced targeting mechanism. The soldier will position the firearm behind an obstacle using a display, and the angled shot pistol mechanism will redirect the bullet in a new direction across the barrier. When engaged in battle in close quarters, a knife gun is able to conceal bullets within what appears to be a knife and release them. In all seriousness, where is China headed? To what extent do they desire progress? Not to forget, Chinese military researchers are also aiming to create super troops with the ability to fight 10 enemy combatants instantly. Moving on to our next highlight, the electromagnetic railgun, EMRG. A year ago, Chinese media said that military railguns would soon be put on Chinese battleships. Not only was that, but images of an ancient tank landing vessel with a prototype rail cannon released on the internet as well. The electromagnetic railgun, which uses electricity to discharge bullets instead of chemical-based propellants, has completely changed the way guns work. This happens by generating high-voltage magnetic forces, which in turn accelerate a metallic conductor sliding between tracks to a velocity of around 7,200 kmph, allowing for the shooting of bullets. The Type 055, China's first defender with a capacity of 10,000 tons, will reportedly be armed with these. On top of that, China has hinted that they are going to use the latest technology to build electromagnetic rockets for their upcoming aircraft carriers. Last but not least, let's talk about the upgraded stealth fighter. An unusual feature for fifth-generation aircraft, a twin-seat version of the J-20 stealth fighter, is being considered for production by China. Air dominance isn't the only thing this plane could do. It could also conduct technological warfare or tactical bombardment operations. One of China's goals is to gain unique aircraft models that no other country has. Along this path, China has been considering creating a twin-seat version of the J-15S used by carriers in an effort to increase the fighter's combat prowess. China crushes the global competition. The fact that the Chinese are gaining ground in the arms war is now widely known. Get ready to be surprised, because what we are going to reveal will blow your mind now. China is not merely causing ripples, rather, it is the dominant power in the oceans. With the largest industrial shipbuilding sector in the world, China easily ranks as the most powerful contender and unchallenged monarch. With consistent double-digit expansion over the past few years, China's shipbuilding sector has maintained its position as the world leader in three critical metrics: shipbuilding results, order intake, and the retention of orders. Besides making ships, the nation's forthcoming orders and standing orders make up a staggering 68.8% and 53.9% of the world's total, respectively. We may claim that China is responsible for the construction of 40% of all ships on the globe. Conversely, the United States and its European allies construct approximately 1%. If they so choose, the Chinese could rapidly catch up to, or even surpass, the United States. China's rise in the Global Military Index, an internationally accepted metric for assessing national power in the realm of military power, is the Global Military Index. This index takes into account an extensive list of criteria to provide a complete picture of a country's military might. Numerous factors, such as regional value, logistical versatility, workforce education and preparedness, technical proficiency, and defense budget distribution are taken into account to figure out the position in this index. Taken as a whole, these factors give an accurate picture of a nation's military might and its capacity for displaying it. With a strong showing in the index in 2023, China is clearly becoming one of the most powerful militaries in the world. China's ranking in the Global Military Index is more than a mere numerical value. It reflects the country's policy, the esteem it enjoys, and the difficulties it encounters in preserving its superiority in a dynamic global defense environment. While planning and technology are important in any war, the value of a large and efficient combat force is tremendous. Thanks for watching. To stay ahead of the latest developments in military technology and power, hit that subscribe button. What are your thoughts on China's military advancements, and how do you think it will shape international relations? Let us know in the comments section.